Yeah, hey Tim, this is the first time this season that you guys have been 10 games over 500. I wonder if you could sum up, you know, what this climb has been, and then, you know, to beat a really good team like Brooklyn, you know, without Porzingis and with, you know, Luka maybe not at his offensive best.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, the story of our season. Just people coming in when their number is called and just going out there and competing each and every possession. So the coaching staff's been hard on us about that and just making sure that we stay disciplined and focused on moving on to the next play, competing on both ends of the floor, and doing what's necessary for the team. And we knew the scenario with the COVID and all the protocols and all that stuff. And a lot of guys, more than half our starters, you know, sitting out for a couple of weeks. You know, that stretch was hard and tough, but we tried to maintain the best we could, and now we're here.
Coop?
Hey, Tim. You know, obviously, this is a very, very competitive game. There wasn't a whole lot of difference going throughout the game. But do you feel as if that your team has learned to compete better as the year has gone on, to where, you know, if Kyrie goes off like he goes off tonight, you don't let it get to you. You just keep playing, as you say, like keep going on to the next play.
Yeah.
Has the heat level gotten higher?
Yeah, that is definitely correct. And I mean, like I said before, everybody knows what time it is. It's that time, and that postseason, you know, energy, that postseason atmosphere, and that postseason grit that you have to be willing to have, you know, moving forward, going into that part of the season. So I think everybody knows it's crunch time. Everybody's trying to build up to that postseason edge and getting ready for that.
Kevin?
Tim, to kind of go along with that, obviously there's pressure to win every single night in this league, but with the way that the season is set up and the playoff stretch going the way that it is there additional pressure to continuously win ball games night over night, knowing what's at stake here?
Yeah, I mean, there's always going to be pressure. That's the beauty of sports. So just being able to go out there and play each possession like it's your last, it's an honor. So, you know, you got to definitely go out there, compete, like I said, on both ends of the floor, no matter who the opponent is, and just try to go out there and win ball games no matter how they come.
All right, and then the last one will be Mike Wesley.
Tim, when you look at what Dorian Finney-Smith has done over the course of the last basically month and change now, the way that he's been such an impact player for you guys on both ends of the floor, what he did tonight against KD, what he's doing at the three-point line, certainly, obviously. When you look at what he's become for this team, how much more dangerous does that make the Mavs as a team as you guys look forward?
It's great because, you know, a lot of teams are putting their weaker defenders, you know, on Dodo. But, you know, Dodo's a very, very versatile and starting to get a lot of confidence now, driving the ball, getting a rebound, pushing it on the break, knocking down walk-up threes on the break, and just doing an amazing job, like you said, on the defensive end, guarding the best player night in and night out. So, you know, kudos to him. He's doing an amazing job, and obviously we wouldn't be in this situation without his play.
All right, awesome.